You're going to have to wear a diaper everywhere you go. You 35 with a diaper on because you've been murdered your whole life. Boy, your back been blown to pieces, literally.
To pieces is crazy.
Yeah. Boy, no way, boy.
Let's get lit.
Shalom, 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 Israel. Most High Christ bless. This brother, we tripping, man. Hold on, man.
We back.
Yeah.
We back.
We in this building. You
know, like
oh, that's that Rambo.
Welcome to Kingdom of Pew Podcast. Pew. I am Officer Benaiah, Officer Avery, shooting with the little pistol.
Yo, pew, pew.
Laser gun.
To my right here.
Officer Avery.
Officer Avery, the light-skinned prophet in the house. Shout out to that.
We in this building.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. To my left right here.
Officer Ariyah.
Officer Ariyah, the Kung Fu man.
What the? You're going to learn today.
To my other left over there.
Officer Becker.
Officer Becker, the oldest prophet in Israel.
Put them on a leash.
And to my far left down there. What's up,
bro? What's good, officer?
What's your name, bro?
Officer Elia.
Officer Elia, man. Brother got bars, man. What's up, man?
Officer Benaiah, right on my record,
man. What's up with the albums, bro? What's up? Well, you got We got a rap duo here in the house. Put the cam on them.
We in this building.
What's up, man? We want the album, bro. We want the album coming out, man.
Hold on. Let me see.
What's up, bro? When is the album coming, man? We need the album, bro. What's up, man? Come on, bro.
I usually ask questions, but I'm going to let my manager handle that.
Hey, what's up?
You don't find that suspicious?
What's up, I'm sorry, y'all. We're coming, man. What's up?
You know, he plans everything, you know what I'm saying?
I usually answer questions, but I'm going to let L.A. out handle that. You know what I'm
saying? I tell you what, there wasn't no Christ. That's what it was. There wasn't no Christ.
A whole lot of deflecting going on over there, bro. Hey, yo, welcome to the show, man. We're going to jump right in. To it.
Hey, officer, before you what's jump up, into it, can I got a message.
Yeah.
Mm.
Go ahead.
Can we play the message for officer?
Oh, what do we have here?
Try my tactics.
It's a public announcement, bro.
Okay. What's the
public announcement, bro? Straight off the press.
Hey, shalom. Officer Benaiah, we got a special announcement just for you. Hold on.
Hello. So I got a question. You coming out for Officer Aaron because he light skinned. Ain't you light skinned too?
We in this building.
Yeah. Hey, out of the mouth of babes, officer. No, sir, I am not light skinned. Hey, you kids out there.
She cut you deep.
It's not light skinned. I'm dark skinned.
Hey, bro, look.
This guy right here, bro.
I ain't have nothing to do with it, bro. You know,
that's what they were talking to you.
So the kid walked up to you and
said.
Come on, bro.
He ain't coerced them now.
The baby walked up to me and said, I got something I want to say, officer. And that's what she said. I said, hold on, baby.
You're going to learn today.
Let's get this. I want evidence. You know?
Right.
I was trying to leave, bro. The baby came and got me, pulled me by my coat tail.
She pulled you by your coat.
Yeah, shirt tail, you know.
I don't know.
By the hem of your garment.
But since you got a video, officer.
It was coerced.
Hey, look, I got a call today, bro.
Uh-oh.
I got a call from one of them dogs you got at the house.
Oh, damn.
You that video, David, Officer Aaron's dog.
Uh-oh, what's going on here?
The dog, Officer Aaron got dogs at the house, right? Now, you keep dogs, right, Officer?
I
got a call for the dog. This is what the dog said.
I'm a black-owned dog. Of course I wasn't bought at a pet store. I was found on Facebook.
I'm a black-owned dog. Of course, the only time they take me to the vet is if they think I'm dying. I'm a black-owned dog. Of course, I have a name, but most of the time, it's...
Hey.
I'm a black-owned dog. Of course, I'm not allowed to ever kiss my human in the mouth. I'm a black-owned dog. Right. Of course, when we go to Petco, I bet not touch nothing or ask for nothing. I'm a black-owned dog. Of course, I'm not allowed on the bed or furniture.
Hey.
I'm a black-owned dog. Of course, I have to hide in the closet when maintenance visits the unit.
Do you have a dog?
Nope.
Hey, you know black folk, man. You know you got a dog in your apartment. You can't have no dog in the apartment.
No, can't have no dog.
The dog gotta be quiet. You get in there, you be quiet.
You talking to the dog like a child.
When they doing that inspection. You know, you had an apartment that you do the monthly or quarterly inspection. The dog gotta hide. You gotta take the dog from the house.
Even the dog being quiet.
The black owned dogs got it hard up in this chat.
Right. They curse too. They curse.
Hey, yo, before we get into the show, officer, let her get us opening the scripture. Give me the book of Exodus chapter 19, verse 6. Read that.
The book of Exodus, chapter 19 and verse 6.
Uh-huh. Read it out.
And ye shall be unto me a kingdom of priests.
You hear what God say to the blacks and Spanish and Native Americans today? You are a kingdom of priests. All you got to do is repent and keep the laws of God. God say you're above all nations on the earth. But we must repent and keep the commandments. Read on.
Read and holy, and ye shall be unto me a kingdom of priests.
Read.
And an holy nation.
Uh-huh.
These are the words which thou shalt speak unto the children of Israel.
You see that? God said we're a kingdom of priests. All we got to do is repent and keep the commandments of God, and we will be that kingdom of priests.
Right.
But
right.
Yo, let's jump right into it. Give me that first installment of the day.
Day off the weed.
Yo, hey, bro, look, y'all know what time it is, right? It's tax time again.
Yeah.
So you start seeing all the ads that's geared toward our people, the 12 tribes of Israel, to take their money at tax time. Play that video.
Come and pay your taxes. Come and pay your taxes. Come and pay your taxes. You know you want that.
Hey, hey, hey.
Catch that van. You want that cash advance, you better bow, 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 bow.
Swallowed hey, up. Hey, have hey, you hey. Ever been swallowed
bow,
up?
Bow, 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 bow. Hey, 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 hey. Coming up
also,
we gonna hook you up. We gonna
power, man. See, this, bro, this stuff right here, man. It's gotta stop, man. It's gotta stop, bro. Our men flashing around like this, bro. It's pathetic, bro.
It's flamboyant.
Bro. It's flamboyant. Well, why would you want to put... You know who gonna go flock to them people to get their taxes done? The black woman.
Mm-hmm.
Because she like that crap.
Right.
The black woman like to see our man like that, bro.
Yeah.
That's evil according to God. I'm going to read something. Give me that scripture in 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 9. That right there is called effeminate. That's an effeminate man. Now, he brought a gay. I don't know.
I don't even think it's a probably.
He's more than likely gay. Now, he doing a video, a commercial to come file your taxes. And our people... I wouldn't go to an establishment like that to file no taxes.
Oh, no.
It's very unprofessional.
Unprofessional.
Right. It's horrible, bro.
Right.
But those people, I bet they busy right now.
Mm-hmm. Hell no.
Parking lot
they
full.
Swamped.
Swamped. Right parking now. Lot swamped because of ad like that. That's how destroyed the mindset is of the 12 tribes of Israel.
Dang. Okay.
Mainly Judah right there for that right there.
Mm-hmm.
Come and file your taxes. Who song that is? He
sound like Sexy Red.
That's some Sexy Red garbage.
Probably so.
And he dancing like Sexy Red. Bruh, I'm telling you.
Back all bent.
Yeah. So you see the broken wrist? That's some evil shit right there, man. Read that. I want 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 9.
1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 9.
Uh-huh.
Know ye not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God?
You hear that? God said the unrighteous, the people that's not keeping the commandments of God, will not inherit the kingdom of God because You know what Paul had to put this in there? Because the Christian church today tells you it's all right. Now, that dude right there in that video is probably in the choir somewhere.
Oh, yeah.
He's in the choir, and his pastor is not telling him what he need to do to get salvation. Mm-mm. Read on.
Be not deceived. Uh-huh. Neither fornicators, nor idolaters.
You see that? Fornicators ain't going to get the kingdom. The damn Christian church full of fornicators. Mm. Full of fornicators. You and your old lady at church today. Okay? Mm-hmm. You and your two hoes at church today.
Damn.
That's what goes on. I'm telling you. Some of you black folks been in the church for 30 years and ain't married. Mm-hmm. And your pastor don't say nothing to you.
Right.
That's some evil stuff. But God say, if you're a fornicator, you having sex out of wedlock. Mm-hmm. And you ain't going to get the kingdom. Read on. Right.
Nor adulterers.
If you're an adulteress, a lot of y'all in the church with your wives, your spouse, but didn't come home to that damn morning.
Dang.
You didn't come home to that morning. You was out with the side piece, with the jump off. And the pastor don't say a damn thing, and you know the pastor know about it. Mm-hmm. Read on.
Nor effeminate.
Nor what?
Effeminate.
That's what that brother is right there, effeminate. Super. This brother is effeminate.
Mm.
Super effeminate. That's all what he looked like right there. That's what he looked like.
All the way.
Damn, bro.
Look at that, bro.
That's that bug off
that's
of
that bug.
Men in Black.
Men in Black or so?
Yeah. That's that bug off.
Like, your back shouldn't have that much of a curve in it.
That brother back is curved. But, brother ain't got no backbone.
But the thing about it.
Literally.
Who, our people flock to stuff like this. I remember living in Memphis, bro. And it was this dude came on every year about taxes. Come over here and file your taxes. With, you know, have rap music playing, look, black kids rapping. And, bruh, he stayed packed because our people just destroyed. We should think that that's not a good business.
Right.
Do our business with.
Right.
Okay? Put the video back up, bruh. Finish it. Did we finish that scripture?
Not yet.
Okay, I'm sorry. Hold on for y'all play the video. What we was at?
So, nor effeminate, nor abusers of themselves with mankind.
You see that? Nor abusers of themselves with mankind. You men that let men run up in your rectum.
It's abuse.
That's abuse. You abusing yourself. You women that letting another woman to put a scrap on and run up in you.
Dang.
You's abusing yourself.
That's right.
Some evil stuff right there, that's man. Right. You men that are taking, just bent over.
Dang.
You damn. Broke back mountain Negro.
Swallowed up. Have you ever been swallowed up?
You are abusing yourself. That's what's going on. You're abusing yourself, bro. And then a lot of y'all, when you get to a certain age, you can't even use the bat. You're incompetent. You're incompetent because you can't even hold your stuff. You got to put a pimp on.
Damn.
Because it ain't no stopping it when it's time to go because you done been destroyed. Your back been blown out, literally.
Opened up back
you
there.
Opened up. You,
wow.
I just seen a video on it, bro.
You stretched out.
Dang.
That muscles is too weak. The whole your bow, I'm telling you, bro, I made this up. I seen a video.
What?
I seen it on the internet, so you know
bro,
it's true.
Bro, what are you talking about, man?
I seen it on the internet, so you know it's true. If you let a man abuse you like that, eventually you ain't going to be able to hold them muscles. And it's going to be bad day for you, bro. God. I'm telling you, you're going to have to wear a diaper everywhere you go. You 35 with a diaper on because you've been murdered your whole life.
God, destroyed.
Your back been blown to pieces, literally.
To pieces is crazy.
Bueno, wait. No. Your muscles is loose.
You just ain't got no integrity.
Blown to pieces.
Yeah.
Smithereens.
Blown to pieces.
Yeah, your muscles.
Shame.
I'm telling you, bro. But God say, people like that, read that part again.
Nor abusers of themselves with mankind.
Uh-huh.
Nor thieves.
Uh-huh.
Nor covetous.
Read.
Nor drunkards.
Nor what?
Nor drunkards.
All you people out there like to get drunk. God said you ain't going to get the kingdom if you're a drunkard. Read on.
Nor revilers.
If you're a reviler, you ain't going to get the kingdom. Read.
Nor extortioners.
Uh-huh.
Shall inherit the kingdom of God.
You see that? But I bet the Christian church don't never read that.
Oh, no.
No, sir.
They don't read
no,
that. Sir. Because everybody mm-hmm. had to get up and walk up out that job.
Yeah. Too much money lost.
Put the one finger up and walk out.
Too much yep. money.
All the black yep. women going to have to get up and walk up out of there when mm-hmm. they say no fornication. Because mm-hmm. all of them ain't married. All of them single in the church, but they still having sex.
Right. Right.
They fornicating. The whole damn church full of fornicators.
Yep.
But, they up in there giving their testimony.
No,
you in there giving your testimony. I love the Lord. And learn a lot of wrong. Get out there. Get the hell out of here.
That's right.
Damn black devil.
Like, not my guy.
Hey, play the
not
video.
My Lord.
Hey, did we finish God. The video?
Mm-mm. Not my Jesus.
All right, play it.
We gonna make sure you get that back paper. Yeah. You got a couple kids. You don't have no job.
Yeah.
Don't worry about it, little girl. That's my job.
Yeah.
Come and find your Texas.
Cut, man. This is some straight garbage right here, bro. Lord will that brother repent. Yeah. Lord will he see this and repent, man. Because he ain't going to get the kingdom of heaven like that.
No.
Lord will the brother repent. Hey, give me that next installment of the day. The one that's a freak. Hey, look, shout out to the bishop, the leadership. Bishop said something a few weeks ago. And then I saw this video, made me think about what he said. All you brothers out there, you sisters and brothers out there that watching porn, you sisters and brothers out there watching porn, it's a gateway to more stuff for you.
Mm-hmm.
You, especially you men out there watching porn, you're going to turn into a homosexual.
Damn.
Watch this.
Straight like that.
Watch this. Watch this.
Damn.
Play the video.
Because you like women as well, right?
Oh, yeah. Okay. I love women. I'm attracted to feminine. I'm straight feminine. I like straight feminine. Men do not attract me. You know what I'm saying? But I'm just a freak though. You know what I'm saying? So
okay.
That's how I got on trans because it started with just some porn. You know what I'm saying?
So but in the trans a man.
Hold on. Did you hear what he just said?
Yeah.
He said he got on trannies from watching porn. That's how he got. That's how he started messing with trans.
Damn.
Trans. Because he started off watching porn. And there's a lot of our brothers in the truth, in the world, or in the truth, that watch porn. I'm telling you, there's a lot of brothers that do that, battle with that stuff. You got to repent from that. You got to, if your right eye offended, you got to cut it off.
Right.
You might need to get your internet cut off. I don't know. You might need to get rid of your phone. Get you a flip phone.
Right. You can't watch videos on that.
Right.
You can't watch videos on your phone. You got to get you a flip phone. If it's dealing with your salvation,
right.
It's worth it to get a flip phone or some phone without internet,
right?
Or something,
right.
Okay. Can y'all bag it up a little bit, or you got to play the whole thing? Okay, just a little. I want y'all to hear what he said. Play.
That's how I got on trans because it started with just some porn. You know what I'm saying?
So, but in the trans a man though.
But no, I don't. So how am I supposed to know that? It's
huh? Well, don't
if they're
what? Paul, bruh.
What?
Bruh.
What?
You say the brother asked him, ain't trans a man? He's like, oh, how I supposed to know that? Well, hell, you need to do a reach around something, bro.
Something. how you supposed to know that?
Man, I'm
crazy, it's man. A trans.
It's a trans.
Why is it called a trans?
Right.
He didn't want to say it, bro. He didn't want to say it, but he know when he's dealing with men.
Yeah.
You know? But I'm going to tell you something, bro. I'm telling all you whoremongers out there, if you in there a whoremonger in 2024, you need to turn the damn light on.
Damn,
I'm just telling you the truth. You need to turn the light on because ain't no damn telling what you getting.
Damn.
You might be getting 4 holes, 7 holes. I don't know what the hell going on. God damn. All kind of surgery going on in this joint. Man, you know. Man, who knows what you're going to get today?
You just can't.
But the porn is a gateway. Shout out to the bishop. The bishop brought that out.
He did.
And when
did.
He heard it, when he said it, he when he said it, I was like, damn,
it made a lot of sense.
Made a whole lot of sense, bro.
Whole lot of
sense. So this video is proof that what the bishop said is on point,
on
man.
Point.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
I'm telling you. Go back to the video.
Damn.
The penis, right?
Yeah, but they got titties too.
Damn!
Brother,
come on, man. Give me that scripture, Matthew
Fat
chapter
dudes
5.
Got titties too.
What the hell?
Give me that scripture, Matthew chapter 5, verse 28.
Come on.
Matthew chapter 5, verse 28. All you brothers out there that watching porn, it's sin. It's sin. I pray you repent from that. Watching porn is sin. You know, if you battling with that, make sure you fast and pray to get that spirit up off you, because it's going to lead you into homosexuality or some kind of inordinate affection like this brother battling. He said, yeah, it's a penis, but it is also titties. What would that mean?
They got titties.
Hell, yeah. Ain't no telling what you get. You got a penis at the bottom and titties at the top. They got a song.
Yeah.
I seen it.
Yeah.
Penis at the bottom, titties at the top.
You lying.
Damn. Yeah, I seen it. They got a song. Dang. Penis at the bottom, titties at the top.
Wow.
So
it's new or something?
Bro, I just seen it on Instagram somewhere. Yeah, it's an action.
That's crazy, bro.
Read that scripture. I'll say even look for it, because brother don't believe me. Read that.
Matthew chapter 5, verse 28.
Uh-huh.
But I say unto you,
uh-huh,
that whosoever looketh on a woman,
uh-huh,
to lust after her.
That's what you're doing. That's what you're doing when you watch porn. You looking up on the woman to your brothers now, because some of you brothers might be Googling dark trannies.
Oh my God.
Lady boys. If you into all that right there, you got to pray to the Lord to get that spirit up on you. The good thing about us, the 12 tribes of Israel, we got Christ. We can repent.
Right, right.
We can repent from that stuff. Read that again.
But I say unto you,
uh-huh,
that whosoever looketh on a woman,
read,
to lust after her,
uh-huh,
hath committed adultery with her already in his heart.
You see that? You already then committed adultery with that woman in your mind. Okay, and some of these brothers, man, and like I said, the leadership brought it out. Some of them only want to look at certain porns with men with penis sizes and all that stuff. Man, I'm telling you, that's the gateway straight on into homosexuality. So, hey, brothers, if brothers doing that, we got to repent from that. We got to come up out of that,
mm-hmm,
all right? You find that out? If not, mm-hmm, don't worry about it.
Yeah, okay.
You found it?
Yep.
Damn, bro, I don't even know if we ought to play this.
hey, I was going to get scripted on that right quick.
Go ahead, go ahead.
Hey, man, you know, like I said, the brother like the titties and the penis.
Right.
You know, that's what we got to do. Right. Go to 2 Corinthians 10 and 5, man. Because, you know, here in Babylon, everything goes.
Mm-hmm.
It's all right to have sex with another man, a woman on woman. Mm-hmm. But we got to do this right here. Read that.
2 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 5.
Read out.
Casting down imaginations.
Casting down all the imagination. We got to get this stuff out of our head, man. You know, we got to cast down that thought process and which caused us to go against God's law, right? Read that. Read the rest of that.
And every high thing that exalted itself against the knowledge of God.
Because porn goes against the knowledge of God. Because what God say? Hey, a man should not lie with another man like he lied with a woman.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, you're supposed to get married, a man and a woman. That's what the Bible say. But hey, what the imagination of this Babylon say? Hey, we can do all things that go against God's knowledge. All right, read the rest.
And bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ.
Now, that's the thought process we got to have according to God's law, statute, commandments.
Right.
You know, hey, I can't do this nasty stuff. Hey, man, hey, I got to get right with the Most High God. I got to repent and do God's law, statute, commandments, and so we can make this kingdom cost. Hey, you're not going to make the kingdom by thinking about a man, loving a man that got breasts and a penis. I don't get it.
I
don't get you that damn fire.
Don't got a penis?
That's
got breasts too, though.
It's a lake of fire. You find it, officer?
Yeah.
Did y'all, get it? Y'all get that with officer sent over there? We definitely don't want to play the whole thing.
what's the name of the song?
Y'all see it, IT, or not? Right, how long is it?
Titties at the top and at the bottom.
That's the name of
That's
it.
That's the name of the song.
God, yeah.
Who sang this song?
Hey, put it up real quick, y'all. And
dude, got a.
Oh, yeah. Damn, that is a trans.
Is that a trans?
Got to be.
Mm-hmm.
It ain't no woman.
I got titties at the top and dick at the bottom. Titties at the top and dick at the bottom. Titties at the top and dick at the bottom.
All right, take it out. Look at it. Look at it.
She's a
Christian, bro. It's a Christian. I'm sorry. I say, yeah, it's. Man, I say, I'll be getting confused, man.
Yeah.
That. So they. I know I had seen that crap somewhere before, bro. That's some evil stuff, man.
It was a viral song, bro.
It was viral.
Man. Yeah, viral.
God.
Wow.
Man. Oh, my God.
So that's what y'all like.
I'm putting scripture on that.
Yeah, go ahead.
Let me get on Isaiah chapter 3, verse 8.
Bring it out. That's some evil stuff,
bro. That's some evil stuff. I really didn't believe y'all.
Yeah, like, hey, bro, I'll tell you, I saw it, man.
I really thought y'all were lying.
Yeah.
Bro, nowadays, you got to damn near believe everything.
Right.
It's just crazy. It's out there.
It's 2024.
Yeah. Hey, go ahead, Austin.
Isaiah chapter 3, verse 8.
Mm-hmm.
For Jerusalem is ruined, mm-hmm. and Judah is fallen.
Look, that's our people that we just seen on that screen. Even the boy with the taxes. Mm-hmm. Judah falling right now. Mm-hmm. Keep going. Why?
Because their tongue and their doings.
It's singing a song mm-hmm. about having titties. It's a man that's singing about having titties at the top mm-hmm. and what you're supposed to have at the bottom.
Wow.
Wow.
You agree. Mm-hmm.
Because their tongue and their doings are against the Lord to provoke the eyes of his glory.
Keep reading.
The show of their countenance doth witness against them.
What it do?
And they declare their sin as Sodom.
What? Mm-hmm.
They hide it not.
They got pride in this thing, man. They don't care about what the Lord say. They trying to provoke him to anger. They got a cross. Mm-hmm. It got a cross behind her.
Right.
Singing about having titties you're not supposed to have mm-hmm. and a dick. Mm, yeah. I ain't know what to say. I was
Transformer. We gotta be honest here. Look, we gotta bring stuff like this out because it's what our people is going through. It's what the 12 tribes of Israel going through, and we gotta correct them with the scriptures. And you haters out there that be coming on our show talking about we laughing too much. You ain't got to watch.
They got titties at the top and a dick at the bottom. Yeah.
Hey, you don't nigga, get. I bet they ain't getting on that video there.
No, they ain't getting on there saying nothing.
Nah, they in the closet dancing.
They putting flames and hearts on in the comments. That's what they doing.
Yeah, man.
But about it, laughing ain't a sin.
Shut your black ass up.
Laughing is not a sin.
Give me that scripture in Psalms chapter 133, man. So they getting on our videos, to our show, and saying that we laughing too much. We shouldn't be laughing like that. Why not?
What you mad for?
The scripture say how good and pleasant it is. Read that.
Psalms chapter 133, verse 1.
Uh-huh.
Behold, how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity.
What you see, brother, dwelling together in unity. So guess what? When we dwelling together in unity, we laugh. We have a good time.
Mm-hmm. Right.
This is a podcast.
Right.
You know, we got classroom videos.
Right.
Mm-hmm. All that. If you more in tune with a classroom video, you should watch that.
Right.
But to come on the show, you probably just got cut.
Mm-hmm.
You probably got cut. You might like the titties at the top mm-hmm. and penis at the bottom. And you come in because you hate that.
Right.
Because we bringing that sin out and showing you.
Right.
And then bringing the scripture with it. That's what the problem
That's
is.
That's what it is.
That's what it is. Right.
That's what it is.
Upset.
They just getting upset. You get mm-hmm. you because the scripture. Watch this. Give me that scripture in Hebrews chapter 4 and verse 12.
Mm.
What happened is when we bring out these scriptures, it cuts your spirit. It cuts your spirit. The word of God is like a two-edged sword.
Mm-hmm.
Read
mm-hmm.
that.
Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12.
Read it out.
For the word of God is quick
uh-huh.
and powerful.
Read.
And sharper than any two-edged sword.
You hear that? The word of God is powerful. And shout out to the leadership they was bringing out. When Christ come back, he's going to destroy you with the law. Right. Meaning if you over there and you a homosexual, and he going to say, hey, no homosexuality. Boom, you're going to bust into a flame of fire.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Disintegrate.
If you in the midst of fornication, no fornication. Boom, you bust into a puff of smoke
mm-hmm.
with
mm-hmm.
the word. Mm-hmm. See what I'm saying? So we out here trying to correct our people. Right. And you got haters online
mad.
Talking crap mad.
Seriously mad. Upset because we laughing.
Leaving long comments. Because we correcting our people, the 12 tribes of Israel.
Mm.
Who else trying to restore our people out here?
Nobody.
Nobody trying to restore.
That's some miserable stuff right there.
Yeah, now, you mad.
Now, it was being said, we're a hate group, right?
Yeah.
Right, right.
Now you're mad because we laughing.
We laughing too much.
Yeah. I wish y'all just go back to hating people.
Yeah.
Be a hate group.
Yeah, they laughing too much. I thought they number three. They number three on the list. How you all see number three on the list?
Come on here and frown up the whole show.
You know what I'm saying?
Because we hate people.
You know, stop they say smiling. We mean.
We going to stop getting married, too. We going to stop promoting marriages and black families, too.
Evil stuff,
ain't no
man.
Sin in laughing.
Bro. Right. You know, did we finish that? Did we finish it?
No, sir.
Okay, read again.
For the word of God is quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword, piercing even to the dividing asunder of soul and spirit.
That's what happened. When that word of God come out, it cuts your spirit. And when we bring out stuff like this, you just get mad.
Right.
You a whore, probably. You a whore. We bring out videos on being a hoe. And a lot of women don't like it. We brought out some video by Sister Smelling. Folk got a lot of.
You
got
to take pH. The pH balance.
You know, y'all just don't understand
the pH balance of a woman.
You don't understand the pH balance of a woman.
We understand the scripture. We understand the Lord.
Why your pH balance off? Because you got too many rods.
That's what it is.
Too many rods.
Take them tight pants off.
Yeah.
Right.
Damn.
Right.
Got too much nut in you.
Damn.
My bad.
Hey, bro, this is a family show.
It is. My bad.
Family show, my brother. What's wrong with this guy?
They going to hate you because you speak the truth.
Right. They hate who rebuking the game.
Hey,
if I become your enemy?
Can I get a scripture?
Yeah.
Okay. I was going to laugh back on what he said earlier about brothers dwelling together in unity. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
When we come together like this, yeah, we have a good time. We supposed to. You know what I'm saying? Give me Ecclesiastes 3 real quick.
Oh, yeah, you're right, though.
Ecclesiastes 3, read verse 1.
Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 1.
Mm-hmm. Read out.
To everything there is a season, and a time to every purpose under the heaven.
Mm-hmm.
A time to be born, a time to die, a time to plant, a time to pluck up that which is planted,
mm-hmm.
a time to kill, and a time to heal,
read.
And a time to break down, and a time to build up,
mm-hmm.
a time to weep.
It's a time to weep.
Mm-hmm. And a time to laugh.
There's a time to laugh. When we come together in unity like that, it's time to have a good time.
Right.
We
right.
enjoy each other's
right.
company.
Right.
What's wrong with that? Ain't no sin in that.
Right.
Now, you got a lot of people that'll say, well, see, y'all laughing at this. This homosexual, y'all
calamity.
Mentioned right. that our people's calamity, right?
Yeah.
Right. Give me Proverbs 1 now.
Remember, well, you're good.
Remember that we, right. we created in the image of God.
Right.
Now Christians will say that, right? Mm-hmm. I'm made in God's image. Well, we're finna show you an image of God real quick. Give me Proverbs 1 and verse. Let's see here. Let me pull it. Let me get to it. Proverbs 1 and verse 26.
Proverbs chapter 1, verse 26.
Mm-hmm. Read it out.
I also will laugh at your calamity.
This is the Lord now. The Lord said, I will laugh at your calamities.
Mm-hmm.
All right, go ahead.
I will mock when your fear cometh.
You see that? The Lord said, he'll mock, he'll laugh. Why can't we laugh? What's wrong with us laughing? Is it sin?
No, sir. Yeah,
so, I mean, what's the problem?
Hell no.
Hey, read verse 25.
Go ahead.
Verse 25. But ye have set at naught all my counsel.
See, that's the reason why.
Mm-hmm.
God said, you're not listening to none of my counsel,
mm-hmm.
right? If the Bible, do the Bible promote being gay?
No.
It don't. Mm-mm. The Bible say, don't be homosexual.
Right.
So
right.
when you do it and you suffer the consequences, God gonna laugh.
right.
He gonna laugh
right.
at you.
Right. And right. what I do with my children, my damn child. like, hey, stop doing that. And when something bad happens to you, I'm going to laugh first.
Right.
You got to pick yourself up.
Right. Like the sister was eating rat last. What was that? Last week?
Oh, yeah.
Week?
Broke out.
Before last. We showed a video of the sister eating the rat. You know what I'm saying? A neck swole up.
Yeah. Right.
The Lord laughing at
like, right. her. Right. Lord is
because he told you not to do it.
All right.
You had something else?
Nah, that was it. I'll pray to
the Most High.
You smooth.
Hey, go back. Give me that. Did we finish that video? We finished it, right? All right, give me that next installment of the day about your boy Kevin Gates. Y'all seen this?
Mm-mm. Ain't no telling what he's
doing. Ain't no telling, bro.
Oh, Lord.
Yeah, give me that next one, your boy Kevin Gates. All right, play that.
It's in your mouth.
Yeah, I had a woman pee in a cup while we was driving.
Yeah, I seen
trunk.
This, though.
Oh, okay.
Period. Right, though.
Yes.
Because it was just nothing. I was so infatuated with this woman to where it was just nothing about her that was nasty. Like,
hold up. Did y'all hear what this brother said?
Wow.
He said that he had a woman piss in a cup and he drunk it.
Oh, man.
But that's some sick stuff right here. This is why we do the show. Because we have to bring stuff out like this and show our people that it's wrong. Because a lot of our people has never known that evil stuff like this is wrong in the eyes of God.
Right.
Watch this. Give me that in Colossians chapter 3, verse 5. I want Colossians chapter 3, verse 5. God said we got to mortify our members, all that old freaky stuff, which the world say is good. If you're a freak, They say that's good here. Oh, she freaky.
Right.
She a freak.
Right.
He a freak. He'll do anything.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Right.
And they all smile when they say it because mm-hmm. that's the flesh. Yeah. God said we got to mortify that crap. Read that.
Colossians chapter 3, verse 5.
Uh-huh.
Read it.
Mortify therefore your members which are upon the earth.
Read.
Fornication.
Fornication. You got to mortify. That's in your member. That's in the flesh. Mm-hmm. That's what your body want. But God say don't do it. Mm-hmm. Read on.
Uncleanness.
All kind of manners of uncleanness. Read.
Inordinate affection.
Any kind of sick, inordinate affection, like letting a woman piss in a cup and you drinking it. You're going to get sick.
Right.
You
right.
stupid idiot.
No.
You're going to get sick and get septic and die. You idiot. That's some of the sickest shit I never heard.
Brother,
what you
nasty.
Do? You hold a cup down there for to piss in? And then you drink
yeah,
it up?
And then you put some ice in it.
He what's probably, wrong damn, with this damn. Dude, man?
Swallowed up. Right. Have you yeah, ever been swallowed up?
Yes.
Because a lot of people think this brother wise.
Yeah, oh, man.
Run around here with
hell
no.
his
damn head.
Right. Right. He, talking about he a chief.
And a lot of y'all with the eating ass, I don't understand. That's, listen to me. Piss and bowel movement, that's your waste of your body.
Mm, mm,
God made it so that come out and need to go away. It ain't no good.
We're supposed to bury that.
But if you drink it for some kind of inordinate affection, if you die, God probably going to laugh at you. He going to laugh at your calamity.
He's laughing at his calamity.
Because that's some straight garbage right there. So for you got a celebrity, and you know it's a lot of folks look up to these celebrities, bro.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. And I'm telling you, Esau, the so-called white man, who is the devil according to the Bible, and Amalek, who is also Esau, that own all these rap music companies, record labels and stuff, they know that these dudes putting out evil, and who is affecting? It's affecting 12 tribes of Israel.
Yep.
Judah, mm-hmm. mainly the blacks and Spanish and Native American, but mainly Judah. Well, and Judah seen this video. Now Judah gonna go to his old lady. Hey, can you piss in a cup for me?
Yeah, well, I drink your pee, girl.
I'm feeling freaky tonight.
Yeah. Hell no.
Go back to the scripture, man.
Colossians chapter 3, verse 5.
Uh-huh.
Mortify therefore your members, mm-hmm. which are upon the earth.
Read.
Fornication.
Uh-huh.
Uncleanness.
Read.
Inordinate affection.
That's an inordinate affection. Mm-hmm. Read.
Evil concupiscence.
Any kind of evil concupiscence. Read on.
And covetousness,
uh-huh.
which is idolatry.
And covetousness, which is a lot of our people in the midst of mm-hmm. covetousness. That's why they file all these fake tax returns and all that garbage this time of year, you know, and then end up going to jail for that trash mm-hmm. or having to pay fines for all kind of evil covetousness, which is idolatry according to the Bible. Okay. Y'all have something on that before we move on?
Yeah, I got some. Can Revelation chapter 14, verse 4. Mm-hmm. We'll start with verse 3. Because this man right here, like you said, Kevin Gates, he influenced the community, right?
Mm-hmm.
Our people look at him as a model or a role model. But these guys are not the ones to actually listen to. Read that.
You said 13 and 3 or 14?
14 and verse 3.
All right, the book of Revelation chapter 14, verse 3.
Mm-hmm.
Read it out!
And they sung it as it were a new song before the throne.
See, it's time for us to sing a new song. This right here that we see on the TV and the internet, that song right there is what's hurting our community.
Right.
That's the reason why women is ruling over men.
Right.
You put her piss on a pedestal?
Dang.
What's wrong with you, bro? Read that again.
Mm-hmm. And they sung it as it were a new song before the throne.
Mm-hmm.
And before the four beasts.
Go ahead.
And the elders.
Go ahead.
And no man could learn that song but the 144,000.
Right. The new song is Bible. You got to be a part of the 144,000. Everybody can't sing this. Read on.
Mm-hmm. Which were redeemed from the earth.
Go ahead.
These are they which were not defiled with women.
If you drinking a woman dirty bath water,
ugh.
If you drinking her piss,
ugh.
You are not chosen of God. You are not a leader, bro. So
no,
guess
sir.
What? You got to come back to these law, statutes, and commandments. These
go.
Rappers, what they talking about? Forget it, man. It's going to get us in a world of trouble.
Mm. Kill Brooke. Hey, fighter.
If I'm not mistaken, piss is waste.
That's what it is.
Waste. It's waste, right?
Yeah.
That's what? right. So it's meant to come out of your body to secrete it. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
This brother is drinking it.
Drinking it.
I mean, oh my God, bro. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? I know what's wrong with the brother, though. Mm-hmm. Give me Second Ezra real quick.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, First Ezra real quick. First Ezra chapter 4.
right. Because didn't he say something about being infatuated with her or something like that? Did he say that?
He said that.
Said he was so infatuated with her.
He was so infatuated with her.
He can't see nothing dirty about her. Uh-huh. Wow.
Not
wow.
even her period, nah. Wow. Yeah, think like that.
Yeah, a lot of dudes eating at them.
Yeah.
Damn vampires.
Goddamn vampires. Yeah.
What they call themselves?
Verse 26.
Which verse?
Verse 26.
First Ezra chapter 4, verse 26.
Bring it up.
Yeah, many there be that have run out of their wits for women
mm-hmm.
and become servants for their sake.
Read.
Many also have perished and have erred and sinned for women.
You see that? This brother has this brother right here in error.
Yeah.
He drinking her piss, bro. He out his damn wits.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
This brother went out his mind for this woman, bro. He was so infatuated with her that he drunk her pee.
That's right.
That's crazy.
That's crazy. Let me get a scripture on that, man. Give me Job 15:16.
He found Job a piss refreshing.
That's like, man, a brother to sit there and drink piss. That's nasty, man. You know, that's crazy as hell, you know, but Jacob do that. Jacob say, hey, I drank your piss from that tax money.
Damn.
That.
Damn.
Job chapter 15, verse 16.
Bring it up.
15:16, yes, sir.
How much more abominable and filthy is man which drinketh iniquity like water?
Damn.
You see that? You see, hey, that's what Ryan said. You drinking piss. What's up with this?
Hey,
you know what, Babylon? I mean my mic.
You know what, bro? It don't surprise me though, because the brother worship rocks.
Yeah.
He in Islam, ain't he?
Yeah,
yeah,
you know,
yeah. Right. You're right.
He's a Muslim.
Right. Damn.
He was sat down devout. With Farrakhan.
Yeah.
Farrakhan, you teach me what to drink.
Yeah, exactly. Like, come on, bro.
And bro, I mean, look, I'm telling you, all this stuff that you see online is a distraction. For the 12 tribes of Israel not to wake up. Mm-hmm. It's a distraction, I'm telling you. Watch this. Give me that next astonishment of the day of Sukiyana at the damn Grammys. Lord. You know the Grammys was this past week. And, of course, all of the celebrities going to come out dressed like whores, these women. Mm-hmm. And then the men going to dress like homosexuals.
Mm-hmm.
And we all as black folk going to look up to them like they some kind of damn idols or something.
Right.
Well, they are idols to a lot of our people. Mm-hmm. But look at this garbage right here from Sukiyana. Now, this is. Go back, turn it down a little bit. Now, go back. Now, look at her. She's looking like an idiot with this green hair on her head. We the only people do this shit. Excuse me. Go ahead.
Yeah, this is your little custom Von Dutch customizes this for me.
Look at this guy.
Oh!
All women, the only women gonna come out looking like this, bro.
Yeah. I bet her seat stink.
Bro, I bet her, bro, you if she walk by, you gonna be like, man, what's that smell? Oh,
smell some ass.
Your whole ass out, sis. Your whole ass out. Come on, where is the integrity? Mm-hmm. Where is the integrity of our sisters, man? You got her whole ass out in a dress.
Mm.
Damn.
I'm telling you, the other nation that made this dress was laughing.
Oh, yeah.
Laughing at us.
Von
laughing
Dutch.
At us. Give me that scripture in Psalm chapter 44. You know that one about the shaking of the head? Psalm chapter 44. I'm telling you, these other nations laugh at us. You don't think Esau was in the seats up there laughing at our system?
Mm-hmm.
And our women shouldn't lower themselves to this stuff right here.
Right.
Where's the integrity? God said we the salt of the earth. But you come out looking like this, the salt that lost its savor.
Mm-hmm.
You got what I want? Is it 44?
14.
44, yeah, read that.
Psalms chapter 44, verse 14.
Uh-huh. Bring it up.
Thou makest us a byword among the heathen.
God made us a byword among the heathen. Today they call us nigga.
Right.
A whores, you know, thots.
Yep.
Porch monkeys. And our people living up to that byword, but God did it to us. Who did this to us? The Lord did it. You remember God said, I was going to discover your secret parts.
Right.
You see that? God had discovered our secret parts, like it said in Isaiah 3, for our evil. We don't.
A shaking of the head among the people.
I shook my head when I seen them.
Right.
You think the other nations didn't shake their head?
Mm. Right.
God said we are right shaking now. Of the head amongst the people. Sukiyana with her ass out at the Grammys is a shaking of the head, bro. Mm. That's a damn shame, bro. Read it. Is that it?
My confusion is continually before me.
That's all I wanted. That's all I wanted. She's a shaking of the head amongst the people. That's pathetic, man, to come out just like that.
Right.
God say our women, we the salt of the earth. We the greatest people on the earth. All we got to do is repent, come back to the laws. Okay? God say, watch this. Give me that in Deuteronomy chapter 6.
She got kids, too.
I know she got kids, and that's a damn shame. That's she ought to be embarrassed.
Right.
I want that in Deuteronomy 6 about six when they see us, you know. This, if we keep God's commandments, this is what the other nations going to say to us. Deuteronomy chapter 6 and verse 4.
Deuteronomy chapter 6, verse 4.
Bring it out.
Hear, O Israel.
Hold on. What
are you talking about? Deuteronomy 4 and 6.
Deuteronomy chapter 4.
Deuteronomy chapter 4 and 6.
Bring it out.
Keep therefore and do them.
Talking about the commandments of God. Read.
For this is your wisdom and your understanding in the sight of the nations.
That's our wisdom and understanding in the sight of these nations that hate our guts. We must repent and keep the commandments of God. Read on.
Which shall hear all these statutes and say, surely this great nation is a wise and understanding people.
But we got to be keeping the commandments. When they hear us, when they see us, they're going to say we're wise and understanding people. But today, what they saying? They saying we're shaking our head. But that's what our job comes. We come out, we hit the streets, tell our people to repent, come back, because God wants us to keep his commandments. He turned us to a shaking of the head. Okay. Now, it's another video came out of this sister this week.
Oh my God.
Being a dumbass.
Stupid, man. Dang.
Play that next
it
one,
continues.
Play the next. Shout out to Fix Your Face. They played this the other night. Play that.
What do you know?
That you're a musician. But that's why I'm interviewing you today, so I can get to know you.
So I'm a musician.
Mm-hmm.
What the f- I mean, make magic or something?
Oh.
What is a musician?
I think you're confusing that.
Yeah, I'm not no musician. I make music. I make music. And that's not all I do. I make music, I act. I'm a TV star too, a young mogul.
Just really quick, I think you're confusing.
I'm not confusing nothing because you don't know. You thought that all I was a magician or whatever you said.
See, that's what I think you think I said. No, I said musician, magician.
I don't think, baby. I don't think. What is that? That's ghetto. I don't think.
No, you don't think.
I know.
We know you don't think.
So you think. You
take
it. I didn't say magician. Bro,
that's pathetic right there,
you,
man.
We can clearly see you don't think.
That sister is a bird brain.
And right. They used that white girl to exploit them
people. To mock them.
Yeah.
Because
all she do is interview our people.
Yeah.
And make them look foolish.
Make them look foolish.
Yeah.
And bro, she gave us some good footage on that one.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Hey, give me that next installment of the day. Y'all got it? All right, give me that one. All right, now look at this right here now, bro. I saw this on the internet now. Now, read the top of it. It say, why does my mom always got to do the most? Now, play the video. If that's the mama right there, that's a shame.
And the daughter got to step
in front of the mama, bro. This is some evil stuff, right? This is the state that we're in as a nation of people, bro. Mm-hmm. What happened to our women, bro? What happened to our women? If this is what you glorify right here, bending over, shaking your ass, and this the mama and the daughter is shame on the mama.
Right.
Wow, bro. This is.
It don't get no sadder than that.
Bro, that's some sad, bro. That show you we in a bad state, bro. Watch this. Give me that scripture in Isaiah 60:2. Gross darkness, bro. Mm-hmm. Gross darkness. I thought it was. Did it say on. Go back to the video because I wanted to. Did it say something about mama and granddaughter too or something like that?
Like she in competition.
Okay, why does my mom always got to do the most? Okay, play it again.
Turn the AC on.
All right. Now look, Paul, I'm thinking that I guess the one in the middle was the daughter and the older looking one right there that was bent over shaking is the mama.
Yeah.
But that's some evil stuff right there, man. This is the state that we in as a nation of people, bro. This is how far we've fallen, bro. Our women have become ostriches, like it's saying Lamentation.
Right.
Okay. Read that.
Isaiah chapter 60, verse 2.
Bring it up.
For behold, the darkness shall cover the earth, and gross darkness the people.
The darkness is the sin, the evil that's covering this earth, especially in Babylon the Great. It's all over the world, but here is the Satan's seat. This Satan's seat right here. Mm-hmm. And gross darkness has covered the people. When the mama is setting that type of example for her daughters, bro, you in a bad shape right there. Your nation is done.
Bruh.
The scriptures say God has did us worse than Sodom.
Right.
Damn. He has did us worse than Sodom for our minds to be destroyed like that, bro.
That's right.
And for our minds to be destroyed. Did we finish that? Read it again.
For behold, the darkness shall cover the earth, and gross darkness the people.
Read.
But the Lord shall arise upon thee, and his glory shall be seen upon thee.
All we got to do is repent. God said he's still gonna choose Israel, though. But all our people that don't want to get right, they're going to be destroyed. They're going to be put to death. So, Lord, will our people repent and come back to the laws of God, man. Hey, we got to move crazy, on, brothers. Bro. Give me that next astonishment of the day. The woman that cooked the baby. It ain't no video. What? All right, David, you pull that up for me. Now, I want to read something. It's a lot of us going through all type of stuff, bro. A lot of mental health issues as a people. And all of this stuff stems from us in slavery. And all this stuff happened to us because we disobeyed God's law. Watch this. Give me Deuteronomy 28 and 28, bro. And you put it up for me, Dave. Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 28.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 28.
Bring it up.
The Lord shall smite thee with madness and blindness and astonishment of heart.
God said he was going to smite us with madness and blindness and astonishment of heart because we will not obey. We will not keep his command. We go out, tell our people, hey, stop eating pork. Stop being a homosexual. They don't want to hear us. And stuff like this happened right here because our people will not come back to the laws of God. Hey, can you see that officer right
there?
What
the hell?
It's a Missouri mother.
It says, Missouri mother burns 1-month-old baby to death inside oven, claiming she mistook it for a crib.
Oh, come on,
you
man.
Mistook the oven for a crib. You
hell
had to
no.
turn it on
you had to turn
and
it?
Bake the baby. Yeah. Because I'm telling you, a lot of our sisters is crazy.
That's
a lot of
so
our women
evil,
crazy, got mental man. Issues. A lot of these mental issues is because of the oppression and all that stuff we in as a nation of people. Yeah, but God trauma. Said it was going to happen to us. Read it again, officer, and then take us off so we can read the article. Play Gosh. That. I mean, read that, officer, again.
Missouri mother burns 1-month-old baby to death inside oven, claiming she mistook it for a crib. So it's on site. A Missouri mother was arrested after she accidentally burned her 1-month-old baby in an oven.
How the hell she accidentally?
Accidentally,
how you accidentally burnt the baby up? You baked the baby.
Right.
How you accidentally
put
the baby
in the oven and turned
it on? How you accidentally?
Wow, bro.
Go ahead.
Per the New York Post, the mother, Mariah Thomas, reportedly claimed to the police that she mistook the oven for a crib. The scene in their Kansas City home was described as gruesome by the police, who found the baby badly burnt and unresponsive on Friday.
The baby is cooked. The baby cooked. How the hell you mistook the oven as a crib, bro? No, it wasn't happening. The sister had a damn mental breakdown. And all this mental issues and all these things come from the constant oppression on our people, okay? And it all stems from sin when we come back to it, okay? Watch this. Read that. Go back to Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 5. I want not 28 and 5. I want 29. I want Deuteronomy 28 and 29.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 29.
Bring it up.
And thou shalt grope at noonday.
A lot of our people groping at noonday. It's bright outside. We are the Israelites, but our people can't see that. They can't see. They know it's something there. So they grope in Christianity. They grope in as being a Muslim. They grope as Seventh-day Adventist. They grope as being a AKA. What's all that Greek fraternity garbage? All people always searching for stuff.
Right.
And they can't see, but it's right in front of them that they God chosen people and they must repent. Read on.
As the blind gropeth in darkness, and thou shalt not prosper in thy ways.
God said we're not going to prosper in our ways. Read on.
And thou shalt be only oppressed and spoiled evermore.
Read.
And no man shall save thee.
You see that? We're oppressed and spoiled evermore, and it stems down into mental, it goes and it causes mental issues with our people. So who knows what happened with the sister? I bet the daddy wasn't there.
Right, of course.
The daddy wasn't there. She was by herself. Mm-hmm. The Negro probably moved on, and she lost it. Mm-hmm. She lost it, and a lot of stuff happened to our people because of this. Right. That's why we out trying to restore our people.
Right.
Okay, restore our people, but you know things like this gonna continue to happen to us because God said it was. It is what it is. Okay. All right, y'all have some on there before we move on? Not really.
I don't know. Hey, it's crazy.
I'm thinking about how that baby feel inside that oven.
Right. Like, did you not hear the scream?
Hot.
Yeah, no, we're like, damn.
I know the baby was hollering. You know what I'm saying? But, hey, yo, I want to move on, y'all. Those were the stunts of the day. I want to move on to, this week, bro. One thing about Babylon the Great, man, this place is a dangerous place for the 12 tribes of Israel. This is our prison cell as the 12 tribes. We were brought over here on cargo slave ships to repent, okay? We were brought over here on cargo slave ships to repent. This is our, we came here to serve a sentence. So this place is our prison cell. And the people that hate us gonna always put stuff in place to keep us asleep. Right. One of the main things they put in place to keep us asleep is sports.
Right.
Yes, sir. And this week, the biggest sport event ever is being held, the Super Bowl, man. And guess what? Our people is in full effect this week. Give me that first video I sent you, David, on the Super Bowl. Play that.
Peace up, A-Town.
Right. So our people don't understand that for so long we weren't even allowed to go to a damn Super Bowl. They wouldn't even let black players get in the NFL.
Right.
But today it's all good. You got these damn celebrities pushing the Super Bowl. But these folks hate our guts.
Yep.
But now they can make money off us. So guess what they want? They want us up in there. Yep. Now look, give me that video on Shaq pushing the Super Bowl. Look at this garbage right here. Look at this coon.
Super Bowl fans, Tiesto's not gonna be there, but I'll be in town.
Hey.
You want me to do this? Or what about this?
All right, you take it down. So see, these celebrities is pushing this event. It's just so fun or whatever. This shows you that the celebrities officer is tied into Babylon the Great, which is our prison cell to keep us asleep as a nation of people, man.
Yep.
Not only him, not only Shaq, Snoop Dogg pushing that garbage too. Dang. Give me that video with Snoop Dogg. Snoop Dogg pushing it. All the killers and the gangsters at the Super Bowl. Play that.
Walk into my hotel room and look what's happening. They're not playing. Mr. Wynn, getting us ready for the big game. Bang. Oh, gin and juice. Is it out? Biatch. Get my mind on my money. Get my money on my mind. Oh, shit, is that cake? They made me a gin and juice cake? Oh, that shit is too gangster.
You can take it down. So he promoting the Super Bowl. Snoop Dogg promoting the Super Bowl. All these celebrities is promoting the Super Bowl. But guess what? Our people were slaves in Babylon the Great, and they hate our guts. They didn't even want us at their big sporting event. But before we get there, though, I want to go to the origins of sports. Give me that in Maccabees. I want to go to 2 Maccabees chapter 4. 2 Maccabees chapter 4. And I want to start at verse. This was during the Greek captivity. During the Greek captivity, verse 12. I want to start at verse. Hold on. Let me look at it. Start at verse 7. And then we're going to skip to, I'm going to read 7 through 10, then I'm going to skip to 12.
2 Maccabees, chapter 4, verse 7.
Bring it up!
But after the death of Seleucus, when Antiochus, called Epiphanes, took the kingdom.
Who hated our guts, who murdered us, destroyed us. There was a wicked Greek king that killed the Israelites, that killed the 12 tribes of Israel. Read on.
Jason, the brother of Onias, labored underhand to be high priest.
One of our wicked Israelites labored to become the priest. Read on.
Promising unto the king by intercession 303 score talents of silver and of another revenue 80 talents. Besides this, he promised to assign 150 more if he might have license to set him up a place for exercise.
You see that? That place for exercise is called today a gymnasium. Okay? This is the going into the origins of sports. Read on.
And for the training up youth in the fashions of the heathen.
You see that? Sports is the fashions of the heathens, the other nation. It was never in our custom to play sports. It was never in the Israelites' custom to play sports. Read on.
And to write them of Jerusalem by the name of the Antiochians, which when the king had granted and he had gotten into his hand the rule, he forthwith brought his own nation to Greekish fashion.
You see that? Greekish fashion. Jason took his own nation. That's when we start doing this sports garbage, man. But this wasn't one of our customs right here, bro. Now today is the biggest custom in Babylon the Great and all our people doing it. Okay? Watch this. Skip down to verse 12.
Verse 12. For he built gladly a place of exercise under the tower itself.
Read.
And brought the chief young men under his subjection.
You see that? The same thing they're doing today in the NFL. They got the chief young man, the most athletic.
Right.
The most athletic men. The most athletic of Judah. Most of the league is Judah. Now, I seen an article that's saying that, hey, hold it. Hey, I sent you an article, David. They say that the league is about 57% black in 23. I think they lying. I think it's more than that.
I think it's more than that.
Because, I mean, the scriptures say that he was going to make one people better than the other, greater than the other. We are that people.
Right.
Okay. We way more athletic than the so-called white man. It is what it is. So, we excel in sports because we stronger than the other people.
Right.
You see that I sent you?
You got it right here.
Just the highlight part. Read that also.
What's the percentage of players of color in the NFL? 57.5% of NFL players are people of color in 2023.
I don't know about that. I think it's more, bruh. Read on.
This is a considerable decrease from 2020. Went 69.4%.
Come on, bro. You telling me that it done went down? It's more white players coming out now?
Bro, it's more black quarterbacks than ever.
Right.
So they saying in 2020, it was 69% black. The NFL was 69% black. But now it's saying it's 57. I don't believe that. That's a lie. Read on.
69.4% of NFL players were people of color. More specifically, 57.5% of NFL players were black. 9.4% identify as two or more races.
Blah, 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 blah. Come on, bruh. Y'all know.
So that's us.
Y'all know we make up damn near all of the whole league.
Right.
Patrick Mahomes. In the NBA, we might be 80%. NBA might be 80 or 90% black. So guess what? They pushed this custom out on us by giving us a little bit of money. You know we ain't got nothing. They give us some money, we will play. You know. Go back to the scripture real quick, bro. Verse 12 again. Second Maccabees chapter 4, verse 12.
Verse 12. Mm-hmm. For he built gladly a place of exercise under the tower itself, and brought the chief young men under his subjection, and made them wear a hat.
Verse 13.
Now such was the height of Greek fashion.
You see that? That sports was the height of Greek fashion. It ain't had nothing to do with us.
Nothing.
The Israelites, that wasn't our custom.
Right.
Our custom was Passover, okay?
Right.
Serving the living God. Mm-hmm. Whatever we, God's feast days.
Yeah.
The new moons, tabernacles. This is that's our custom. Our custom was never to take a football and run it down on a field.
Right. Right.
That was never our custom. Nah.
Right.
But today, they made it honorable here in Babylon the Great. Mm-hmm. It's evil. Well, you should hate going to the damn Super Bowl, you blacks here, because they hate your guts.
Right.
They make money off of you. You fall prey here. Mm-hmm. Okay. Finish that, officer. Did we finish it?
Now such was the height of Greek fashions and increase of heathenish manners.
You hear that? The Super Bowl NFL football is an ink. That is a heathenish behavior.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Heathenish manners. When you play football, that's heathenish manners right there. A lot of sisters be, well, well my son play football.
Right.
Well, God says heathenish.
Right.
You know, so if you come get some counsel from me, hey, can my son play? No.
No.
Because what they're going to do, think about it now. In high school football, when is the game?
Friday night.
On the Sabbath. You gonna defile God's laws if you in that heathenish manners.
Right.
You gonna defile God's law. They're gonna have games every Friday night, which is Lord's Sabbath day at sundown.
Right, right.
You gonna be out there playing God, defiling the Sabbath.
Yep.
They out there making money, taking up money, selling popcorn, cooking, all that garbage.
Everything.
Man, they got the popcorn going on a Friday night.
Yep. Yeah. Sure.
Bro, that is against God. Mm-hmm. The Super Bowl against God. It's all evil. It's reveling, it's all evil. It's reveling, it's all evil. They got women naked up there. Mm-hmm. They in Vegas, right?
They in Vegas for the
Super Bowl.
It's going down.
It's going down. They in Vegas, or they was at Vegas, shaking ass, you know? They shaking ass at the Super Bowl. That's some evil stuff right there, man.
Right.
The Super Bowl is just a distraction for the 12 tribes of Israel to stay in sin.
Right. Right.
Because they want you to stay in sin. Long as you in sin, they're going to keep ruling over you as a nation of people. I'm telling you. Finish that, and then we give me that scripture in Judith.
An increase of heathenish manners through the exceeding profaneness the exceeding profaneness.
You know what you say about sports? Exceeding profaneness. Exceeding profaneness. The damn Super Bowl is profane, bruh.
Right.
Damn Super Bowl is profane. All they do is promote whoredom out there.
That's right.
You in Vegas, what they say about Vegas? Sin City.
Right. Yes. What happens in Vegas stays in Vegas.
They promote whoredom, all type of homosexuality, all type of evil profaneness going on right now in Vegas. Mm-hmm. This week in Vegas. Right. Read on.
Exceeding profaneness of Jason, that ungodly wretch, and no high priest.
Right. Read on. Is that it?
Hey, in Vegas, ain't prostitution legal?
From what I hear, it's legal there, right?
Yeah.
Prostitution is legal.
So it's all type of sin.
Now, watch this. Give me that article, bro. Our people love the NFL. Hmm. They love the NFL, but guess what? NFL don't love you. They love your money. Hey, them owners hate your guts.
Right.
I'm telling you. Give me that article about the dark history of the NFL. I don't want to read the whole thing. Read that part, officer.
The dark history of the NFL's original racial sins. In an excerpt from our new audio documentary series, Blackballed, host Chelsea Stark Jones and Lex Pryor explore the rumored gentleman's agreement that segregated the league in the 1930s.
Okay.
The story of segregation in football is kind of a strange one.
Mm-hmm.
Football had existed in America since the mid-1800s, basically since the end of the Civil War.
But it was always wicked sports going on under the Greeks and the Romans.
Right.
The Greeks and the Romans, you know?
It was played mostly at the collegiate level. And by 1890, there were a handful of black players excelling at schools like Amherst, Harvard, and Michigan. This was during the Jim Crow era, but segregation wasn't explicitly allowed.
Read on.
Around the turn of the century, professional football came into being in America. And unlike so many institutions, it did not embrace segregation at first.
You see that? Couldn't no black folk be in the league? Mm-hmm. Couldn't no black folk be in that league? Couldn't black folk couldn't even play in the damn Super Bowl? But today you got folks like Shaq. Oh, yeah. We shouldn't play in that garbage. You see what I'm saying? Black folks shouldn't even play in that garbage. We the 12 tribes of Israel. That's not our custom. Okay. Read on.
In fact, in 1902... the first black man suited up in a pro football game.
They, you know, in America, you try to search on Google the real history. They got all that blocked out.
Exactly. Yeah.
That's why the bishop always got to find books.
Right.
He got to find books because they didn't took all that out. When you Google black history and football, it's gonna pop up stuff. Oh, the first black player, the first black player,
right?
You know, this is the kind of crap that pop up. Mm-hmm. Read on.
His name was Charles Foles. Mm-hmm. They called him the Black Cyclone. Mm-hmm. I know. Anyway, for 4 years, Foles played alongside the white players for the Shelby Blues of the Ohio League. Mm-hmm. To put it in perspective, Foles was a two-sport athlete. And when it came to baseball, he had to play in the Negro Leagues.
You see that? Because black folk couldn't play in the major league. Okay, we couldn't even play with the white folk because they felt like they superior to us.
Yeah.
Okay, read on, essentially.
Essentially, when it came to segregation, football was behind the times. Mm. And they stayed true through the inception of the NFL, which was formed under another name in 1920. Mm-hmm. And even though it was legal to exclude black players in America.
You see that? It was legal to say, no, you niggas can't play.
Right.
You see that? Mm-hmm. You Negroes can't play in this league. They ain't want us. But today, they make millions and billions of dollars off us in this garbage. Read on.
Even though it was legal to exclude black players in America, the league didn't. Mm-hmm. Why do you think that is? Why did baseball have a white league and a black league? And America started to really segregate, but football didn't.
Mm-hmm. It's because our people were so great at it.
Exploitation, you know, money.
They want to make that money. We were so good at it. You know what I'm saying? Now, I want to read another part of down here. You know, they hide all the good articles from us, y'all.
Right.
All right. Hold on. Give me that next article I sent you, David. Hold on. Let me see where that. Yes. Yeah, go with that one. Give me that one right there. Okay. All right. Now this was the Super Bowl last year though, but read that for me.
9 decades after NFL banned black players, Super Bowl, I don't know what that number is the first.
What is that? 30?
That's 50.
Now, what's 30? That L in Romans?
I think
that's 30. That's 37. 37. I think it's 37. Super Bowl 37.
Super Bowl 37 is the first to feature two black starting quarterbacks.
Now, this was last year. When is it, 2022 or 2023?
Three.
It was 2023. Patrick, what's his name?
Mahomes
and the brother from the Eagles.
Let's re-say that. He said it's 57.
Oh, it's 57. Yeah, I'm sorry. Make sure y'all edit that out.
We'll redo it.
You know, I'm butchered it. Okay. All right, read it again.
Jalen Hurts and Patrick Mahomes.
All right, read it again.
9 decades after NFL banned black players, Super Bowl 57 is the first to feature two black starting quarterbacks.
Okay. All right. Now, remember, we was banned from the league. But now we celebrated like we done forgot about all that. All
right.
Our people done forgot about all that. They tell us to forget about everything. That's the past.
How quickly we forget.
But I bet they don't forget.
No.
Yeah. All right. Read that part right there.
The NFL has a long and racist history with black quarterbacks.
Ah, So guess what? They ain't, especially that black, that quarterback position, you know, that's like a leader or whatever. They didn't want to show our people as leaders.
Right.
So it couldn't be no black quarterback. Now, the first black quarterback go to Super Bowl, I think, was in my lifetime. Mm-hmm. And I ain't that old. I remember his name was Doug Williams. Mm-hmm. I think he won it. I don't know if he the first one to play. I remember
the Redskins?
Yeah, he played for the Redskins. That was in our lifetime right there. Mm-hmm. So this ain't been that long ago.
Right.
Because a lot of our people done forgot about that now. Though. Right. Okay, read that again, officer.
The NFL has a long and racist history with black QBs. Mm. There was a time when people questioned if black quarterbacks had the intellectual capability to play the most mentally challenging position in American team sports.
They said about us? They say we ain't smart enough to play quarterback. That's what they said about us, bro. But now we done forgot all about this. We at Vegas spending all our money.
We want to assimilate.
Yeah. We want to be in their custom.
Yep.
We want to be in that lifestyle. Babylon the Great.
We got to prove to the white man that we can do it.
We can do it.
Right.
Let me use your bathroom, Mr. White Man. You know, I want to sit on the same seat with the beast of the earth. You know.
We got to prove to our oppressor that we can. We can be just like you.
Yeah. Right. We can be just like you. Accept us, please. Let us
let
come
me
to
be
the
equal to you.
Let us come in the country club.
We just want to be swallowed.
All right, where we at, bro? Read that again. Mentally. The most mentally challenging.
The most mentally challenging position in American team sports. Mm-hmm. Often praised for their athletic ability. They've been criticized for not having the acumen to be the signal caller for a professional football team.
All right, skip down. Let's say in 1920.
In 1920, when the NFL was founded, Major League Baseball had been racially segregated for more than 50 years. Mm. But football was unpopular and good players were hard to find.
You see that? That's why they let us play. Good players were hard to find.
Yep.
You know.
Team owners figured the public wouldn't care enough to complain about the few black players on their rosters. Mm. In 1933, George Preston Marshall, who owned the only team south of the Mason-Dixon line, instigated a secret ban of black players.
You see that? It was a ban on black players in the league. But today, Jake done forgot all about that. They out there drinking and partying and fornicating in Sin City. Mm-hmm. But It's heathenish customs, bro. It's a heathenish custom.
Can I say something about
that? Yeah, go ahead, bro.
Because especially in Mississippi, because, you know, we from here, right? Mm-hmm. When you look at our black communities and we have our community colleges, a lot of our black players back then, they went to, like, Jackson State.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
They went to Alcorn. Yep. And where Jerry Rice went? Mississippi Valley State.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Okay, you got Jerry Rice. And then you got, what's the guy name? Walter Payton. These are legends in the NFL.
Yeah. Yeah.
These guys end up going into making the NFL better, right? These were black schools. Mm-hmm. They went to the NFL, made the NFL better. But then guess what they did? They started going to schools like Mississippi State and schools like Ole Miss and started drafting the black people to those schools.
Yeah,
and now your black colleges are poor and they're considered
not good
anymore.
Right.
That's how they do. They really flip the script on us and make it seem like we not what
they
we are.
And I thought that's what Deion Sanders was trying to write that.
Yeah.
But he wasn't trying to write it. He was all thinking about his damn pockets.
About himself and his son.
He thinking about his – it was bigger than – him leaving Jackson State, going to Colorado, I was disappointed. Well, I really don't give a damn, but I was thinking about my people. I know they don't understand the truth.
Right.
You know, that's what I was thinking about. And the brother, I don't even watch sports, but I was thinking about his influence on the city in Jackson, which is one of the most oppressed. Our people are more oppressed in Jackson, Mississippi. Than a lot of places here in this country, bro.
Right.
But go back to the article, man. First, I want you to read down, skip down to, let's say, but racist.
But racist assumptions kept black players from the starting quarterback position for nearly another two decades. Mm. Doug Williams became the first quarterback to start in and win a Super Bowl in 1988.
Now, I remember that. I remember sitting down watching it at my uncle's house. the first black quarterback playing in the Super Bowl, to start in the Super Bowl. It was a big deal. It was a big deal. And that ain't been that long ago.
Right. Right.
So these folks still hate you now. Don't think that Mr. Willie Nim done forgot.
Right.
Nah, man, what's a white name? What's one of them white name? Harold.
Harold
okay. That owns the Super Bowl. I mean, that owns the league. Billy Bob.
Sylvester.
That owns the 49ers. You know, the white folk own all that stuff, man. They own all that stuff, man. But and they hate us, bro. Watch this. Give me that scripture in Leviticus chapter 26. Because our people so naive to think now they let us in. They have changed. Mm. They love us. Mm-hmm. I want Leviticus chapter 26. Them folk hate your guts. I'm telling you. Yeah. They want your money. They like that money, though.
Mm-hmm.
Leviticus 26, I want start at 14. I think that was one.
Leviticus chapter 26, verse 14.
Bring it up.
But if you were not hearkening to me.
This is what God told us. If we were not hearkening to him,
and will not do all these commandments.
Uh-huh.
And if you shall despise my statutes,
read.
Or if your soul abhor my judgments, so that you will not do all my commandments.
That's when you don't want to do, when you don't do God's commandments, you hate him. You hate God. You hate his statutes. Read on.
But that ye break my covenant.
Mm-hmm.
I will also do this unto you.
Read.
I will even appoint over you terror.
God appointed over us terror in Babylon the Great because we would not keep his laws.
Right.
The Ku Klux Klan, that was terror.
Yep.
All them white mobs, all that garbage. We were so scared to go outside, bruh. You know, you ever seen that movie Emmett Till? Hmm. Our people was scared as hell.
Right.
That's why a lot of us moved to the north. A lot of us migrate. That's how we get up in Milwaukee,
Chicago,
all that. We was running from that evil that was going down in the South.
Yep,
a lot of our people end up in California running from the oppression. Okay. Verse 17, skip down to 17.
Verse 17.
Mm-hmm.
And I will set my face against you,
uh-huh,
and ye shall be slain before your enemies.
Mm-hmm.
They that hate you.
We were slain before I am, and we still getting killed. Mm-hmm. We were still getting killed. You see the article? Did y'all see the story on the baby that was decapitated? Up in Alabama, they were just delivering a baby and pulled a whole damn baby head off.
Right. Mm.
Oh,
right.
Yeah.
This was last year, but they just had a news story that said that this was a homicide. Right. It just came out this week.
They tried to do that.
That there was
they
a homicide.
Pulled a baby by the head.
Pulled a baby whole head
you
off.
You know, they be twisting the baby.
Mm-hmm.
And tried to say, hey, look, we ain't tried it. It was a mistake or whatever. Wow. Tried to hide it from
the baby. How many times that happened?
Tried mm-hmm. to hide it from the baby. Matter of
medical
fact,
professional.
But
how many times
this is the kind of stuff that happens to us. Mm-hmm. This is the kind of stuff that happened to us. You don't never hear about no white baby head getting pulled off.
Never.
Right.
Never heard
maybe
about no stuff.
Big ass heads, too, though.
Yeah, they got big heads. read that again, officer.
And verse 17,
mm-hmm.
And I will set my face against you,
mm-hmm.
and ye shall be slain before your enemies.
Read.
They that hate you.
They that what?
They that hate you.
Bro, I wouldn't even want to play.
Mm-mm.
I know these folks hate me.
Mm-hmm.
But a lot of our people don't have no choice. We know they want to, you know, they don't know who they are. That's where our job come in at. We telling our people, you are the Israelites. The Super Bowl is not your custom, okay?
Mm-hmm.
It's heathenish customs. We shouldn't be participating in that garbage. Okay, read it again.
They that hate you shall reign over you,
uh-huh,
and ye shall flee when none pursue with you.
All right, give me that scripture in Revelation chapter 18, verse 4. And then you have some more? I want Revelation chapter 18 and verse 4.
Revelation chapter 18, verse 4.
Bring it out!
And I heard another voice from heaven saying,
uh-huh,
come out of her, my people,
uh-huh,
that ye be not partakers of her sins.
That's what God is telling us today.
Right.
Come out of her. The her is Babylon the Great, America. Come out of her, my people. Come out of her. So when you come up out of the ways of America, it's talking about the Super Bowl. It's talking yep. about Valentine's Day.
Yep.
It's talking about Christmas, because that's yep. another stronghold on our people, right. Valentine's mm-hmm. Day.
Right.
It promotes
whoredom.
Yep.
It promotes whoredom. Mm-hmm. Our people are going to be in the midst of whoring our sisters out just in a couple of days.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
In the midst of whoring our sisters out to get to get sex. That's what all Valentine's Day is about.
Right.
It stems from idolatry.
Right.
Okay. So the Super Bowl, Valentine's Day is all a distraction to keep the 12 tribes of Israel in sin. That's all it is, bro.
Right.
Right.
What is it?
And you know what? What I think, too, this is just me thinking now. I think, just like they say, it's got an NFL racist history, right?
Mm-hmm.
I think the Super Bowl is still racist.
Oh, yeah.
Because look at the ticket prices.
Yeah. Right.
Mm-hmm. Have you seen the ticket prices? They ranging from $4,000 mm-hmm. to $90,000.
Mm-hmm.
Which one of us finna be at the Super Bowl?
Right.
Zero. That ain't for us, but we want to go to Las Vegas and party.
Mm-hmm.
That's what we want to do. Right. So they want to take your money, man. That's what they really doing. Mm-hmm. But they making that now for like the entertainers. That's what it's for.
Hey, watch this. Watch this. Give me that one I sent you, said ripped off at all events. You go out there to Vegas right now. All our people out there in Vegas right now getting ripped off.
Yep.
You see that, David? All right, show you. I want to show you what's going on out there. Garbage right here.
Wait, how much is it?
$23
for Gatorade and Pepsi. It's okay. Right. You got it.
Okay.
Thank you.
No, it wouldn't be the first.
I just was shook when you said 23 for. That's crazy.
Thank God I got rid of you take it down. A damn Pepsi, $12. And a Gatorade, $12. $23.
Boy, ain't no way, boy.
$23. Our people getting raped out there.
Hell
man.
No.
Nah, they paying $23 for that. But remember, Bishop been saying, stock up for the famine. Stock
right.
up. I bet don't nobody out there got a what we got
a
supply.
Stockpile.
Yeah, they don't got no stockpile.
No.
And they spending, like you said, them ticket prices, people going missing out on their rent, car notes, bills, just to pay for those tickets.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, it was just a couple of years ago, that halftime show they said was too black when Dr. Dre was
Dr.
on
Dr. Dre. Mm-hmm.
Hey, give me that next article. Mm-hmm. They said that the halftime show was too damn black. But our people have forgot about that already.
Mm-hmm.
They said that it was too black. Because Dr. Dre and Snoop Dogg did the halftime show. It's too black.
Dang. They said they went on.
When is anything going to be too white? My bad.
Ain't no such thing.
It's
too white, man.
Don't
ain't
exist.
No such thing, bro. All right. Go to that article. I want to scroll down. I don't think I want to play the video. Scroll down. It said The blackest. Most woke Super Bowl ever.
Dang.
That's what some guys. That
what?
Was some woman said. That was some woman said. Can you see that off?
Yeah. It say, the blackest, most woke Super Bowl ever. Can't believe I wrote that since this is the Republican NFL. But here we are. Started by again featuring the black national anthem.
Yeah, I remember they did the black national anthem. This was a couple years ago.
Mm-hmm.
They had the black national anthem. Esau was pissed off. Esau was like, well, it's not our country. You know, it's not representation of our country.
That was my Edomite
yeah,
voice.
Yeah, this is the same NFL job, they got saying. Mad when we was taking a knee, right?
Right.
Yeah.
That's the same. Yeah. I'm finna get into that.
Okay.
Now, we took a knee now. We took a knee now. Remember,
mm-hmm.
Colin Kaepernick,
yeah.
They kicked his ass out the league.
He ain't yeah. been back.
For taking a knee because of the violence that they were doing to our people.
Black right. ball. Mm-hmm.
You know, they put him out the damn league.
Can't even get
a ban him. All the owners got together and said they weren't going to play him because he took a knee for their national anthem. And all the blood that's up under this flag here in Babylon the Great.
Mm-hmm.
All the murdering they did here. Mm-hmm. But you had one brother say, well, look, I'm doing this for my people. You had black players talking mm-hmm. about it.
Right.
You yeah. know?
Don't we have freedom of expression?
That's what they say.
Okay.
That's what they say now.
Not when you were citizen.
Yeah.
So if you an organization that's made up of mostly black people, right?
Mm-hmm.
And your people getting murdered and there's no justice for it, mm-hmm. and you take a knee to express your feelings, mm-hmm. shouldn't the NFL support that?
Oh, no.
Nah,
of course bro. Not.
In a predominantly black league?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Bro, they told them players that anybody else do it, they were getting up out of there.
Bro, the president had to step in.
Of the remember United
Trump
States.
Trump was talking about it. Trump said, fire him.
Yeah.
Trump said, fire him. Mm-hmm. He don't want to stand up for our country.
firearm. This is our country.
He was inciting
make
violence,
America,
too.
Make America great again. Hands on them, yeah. Make America great again. Yeah. All right. Read that again, Austin.
The article? Yeah. Okay. It says, started by again featuring the Black National Anthem, Lift Every Voice and Sing, this time performed by Cheryl Lee Ralph. America only has one national anthem.
Damn.
Tweeted Lauren Boebert, leaning heavily on her all caps keys.
You see that? See how you see how they think? You see that? America only has one. Damn the blacks. That's what they saying. Right. This is what these folks think about us. So why the hell we up there spending all our money at the Super Bowl? Mm. Why the hell we out there playing, running up and down the gridiron, as they call it?
Yeah.
These folks hate you, bro. Skip down, where's say Rihanna?
Then Rihanna performed at halftime.
Mm-hmm.
Despite once saying she wouldn't perform in the Super Bowl halftime show because of the way the NFL treated Colin Kaepernick.
But that money.
That motherfucking money.
Money. That almighty daughter. She got her ass out there half naked.
And started shaking it.
Pregnant
and all.
Shaking it. Pregnant. Pregnant and barefoot out there. For that daughter. All right. Read on.
And protesting players.
Mm-hmm.
She was black. She was back.
Mm-hmm.
And make no mistake, Rihanna is one of the blackest, proudest performers of our time.
Mm-hmm. But wait,
there's more.
Read on.
But wait, it gets blacker.
Gets blacker.
Singer Babyface, a generational rhythm and blues singer, sang America the Beautiful before the game.
Mm-hmm.
He produced dozens of R&B hits and won 12 Grammy Awards.
Okay. Now, am I getting confused? Is this the same one? Because, you know, I don't watch the Super Bowl. Hey, this ain't the same one where Dr. Dre was out there?
I can't remember.
I don't know, man. You know, I don't follow the Super Bowl like that, y'all. Okay. But I remember that they were saying it was the blackest Super Bowl.
Read that next part.
Skip down. At this point.
At this point, we had the Black National Anthem. Rihanna performing the two black starting quarterback. Hold on, Rihanna performing and two black starting quarterbacks for the first time ever during Black History Month.
Mm-hmm.
This wasn't the Super Bowl. This was Wakanda.
Damn. Who said that right there?
Wow.
Read on.
Wow.
But wait,
mm-hmm.
it gets woker.
Mm-hmm.
The traditional
flyover.
Before the game was performed by an all-woman pilot team. Mm. The first time ever. Wokety, wokety, woke.
Whatever. All right, skip down. We'll say there was also
a moment when Doug Williams, holding the Lombardi trophy, was introduced to the crowd.
Mm.
He was the first black quarterback to ever start a Super Bowl. One of the ads during the Super Bowl was for a Fox show about farmers dating called Farmer Wants a Wife.
Mm.
And one of the farmers is black.
Mm.
On a Fox show, you know when we got black farmers on Fox, wokeness has run amok.
Yeah, well, that's all I kind of wanted out of that article. We the Israelites, you know. We God chosen people. That is not our custom to be keeping the Super Bowl. These folks hate your guts, man.
Hmm.
They hate your guts. So read that scripture again in Revelation chapter 18 and verse 4.
Revelation chapter 18, verse 4.
Read it out.
And I heard another voice from heaven saying, come out of her, my people,
read,
that ye be not partakers of her sins,
read,
and that ye receive not of her plagues.
You see that? That we receive not of her plagues. So we gotta reform our mind to come up out of the ways of Babylon the Great. We got to remember that God wants us to keep the Sabbath day.
Right.
God wants us to repent,
right,
keep his high holy days. He ain't never told us to participate in a heathenish custom like the Super Bowl and football. All that stuff.
Right.
All that stuff come from the heathen. God didn't give us that. He gave us the new moon. He gave us the Feast of Tabernacles. He gave us Passover. That's what God gave us. That's what we should be glorifying right there. Not the Super Bowl, spending our money on garbage like that. Mm-hmm. You had some?
Spending all our money.
Give me that scripture. You had some else?
Go ahead, officer.
Give me that scripture in 2 Ezra chapter 2, verse 36.
I want 2 Ezra chapter 2 and verse 36. This is what we want right here. We want to come up out of Babylon the Great so we can get the kingdom. Okay.
2 Ezra chapter 2, verse 36.
Mm-hmm. Bring it out.
Flee the shadow of this world.
You see that? Flee. Flee the shadow of this world. All of these customs that they doing out there right now. Mm-hmm. You know, naked ass women mm-hmm. on the strip in Vegas. All kind of evil, unspeakable things mm-hmm. that going on right now, you know, at the Super Bowl. It's all evil, all right? They make it a whole week out there. Mm-hmm. They call it Super Bowl week.
Yeah.
Read that again.
Flee the shadow of this world.
Uh-huh.
Receive the joyfulness of your glory.
Uh-huh.
I testify my Savior openly.
You see that? That's what we got to do.
Right.
We got to refrain from all this garbage and testify our Savior openly. Christ, the black Messiah.
Right.
Christ don't want us to do that garbage, man. Christ don't want us to celebrate no damn Super Bowl. It's all mm-hmm. evil.
Right.
We should be casting this crap down. That's a nation of people.
Right.
These folks hate us. Why would we go spend our money with somebody that hate our guts like mm-hmm. that?
Right.
Okay. All right. Did we finish that?
That was it.
Okay. All right. Y'all had some on that? Y'all go ahead.
Yeah, I just wanted to say, when we started off into this segment of the Super Bowl,
mm-hmm.
you kicked it off with Second Maccabees, right?
Right.
Second Maccabees chapter 4. Showing the origin of sports to right. our people, basically. Because
mm-hmm.
that's where it derives from. Sports derives from the Greeks, mm-hmm. okay? AKA the so-called white man,
mm-hmm.
all right? That's where sports originate from, okay? We read it to you out of the scriptures. We showed mm-hmm. it to you, right?
Mm-hmm.
So give me Proverbs 3 and 31 real quick. Proverbs 3 and 31. Because this is basically what the officer been saying the whole time. This is not our custom. It's the custom of our oppressors. All right? Read what you got.
Proverbs chapter 3, verse 31.
Uh-huh. Bring it out.
Envy thou not the oppressor.
See, this is the total opposite of what we started to do. Mm-hmm. When you read the story in the Apocrypha of Jason, the wicked rich, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. He envied the oppressors.
Right.
Mm-hmm. He brought us into this Greekish fashion.
Yeah.
All right. Go ahead. Read it again from the top.
Envy thou not the oppressor.
And that's what our people do today. They envy the oppressors. We was reading the article, mm-hmm. the article earlier, right. how we wanted to be like these people.
Right.
Mm-hmm. We wanted to assimilate. Right. All right. They didn't want us in the leagues. They didn't mm-hmm. want us playing football, baseball, or none of those things with them, right?
Right, mm-hmm. right.
But they saw it as a source of income.
Mm-hmm.
They saw that it would profit them,
right.
and that's when they allowed us to join, mm-hmm. right? But we wanted to so bad. We wanted to show the white man that, yes, because they were saying that the black quarterbacks were not competent enough right. to lead a system
right.
in the NFL, right?
Right. Mm-hmm. right.
So we wanted to prove that we could.
Right.
The scripture says what?
Envy thou not the oppressor
uh-huh.
and choose none of his ways.
We ain't supposed to choose none of their ways. All the sports is their ways. The NFL, the MLB, the NBA, mm. those are not our customs.
Right.
A lot of people grow up thinking that that's their custom.
Right.
That's their God-given talent.
Right.
No. Your right. God-given talent is to worship him.
Right.
right. Mm-hmm. Keep his commandments.
Right.
Mm-hmm. right?
To
it ain't to play no damn sports.
That's right. right.
Dunking a damn basketball,
yep.
right.
Running up and down the gridiron,
mm-hmm.
that ain't our custom.
Nope.
You know what I'm saying? Yep. We got to come out of those. A lot of our black mothers push their children mm-hmm. to play all these sports.
Yep.
Oh, yeah.
You got to make it for mama them, mm-hmm.
yeah.
right?
Mm-hmm.
No, bro. You got to keep the commandment. You need to make it to the kingdom
right?
right.
for
right.
your own
and
self.
And these folks hate your guts. How many black people I know just in this area love the Cowboys.
Oh, no. bro.
That's all yeah. on our yeah. job.
America's
That's
team.
All
bro.
They talk about.
Yeah.
Give us that photo of Jerry Jones that you sent.
Yeah.
Jerry Jones, you remember this came out a few months ago.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Jerry Jones was in the middle of trying to what was the
It was a sit-in.
It was a sit-in.
This was a sit-in.
It was a sit-in and Jerry Jones was leading a damn pack. mm-hmm. to get the damn black folk thrown out.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Jerry Jones hates your damn guts.
Right.
And you black folk love the cowboy.
Yeah.
Our people love the cowboy.
Damn.
Jerry Jones hates your damn guts.
Look at the date. This was 1957.
Mm-hmm.
That wasn't too long ago.
No,
you know what I'm saying?
Too long ago.
That wasn't too long ago. And you think that that man lost that racism that's in him?
No.
Hell no.
And he taught it to his kids.
Exactly.
And his great-grandkids, the old bastard.
Yeah.
You know, they hate your guts, man. But go give me that scripture right quick in Maccabees chapter 4. We didn't even finish reading it, bro.
Yeah.
We didn't even, we got to go back to it, man. We got to go back to it. I want to read verse 14. I want 2 Maccabees chapter 4. 2 Maccabees chapter 4 and verse 14.
2 Maccabees chapter 4 and verse 14.
Uh-huh.
That the priests had no courage to serve anymore at the altar.
Read.
But despising the temple and neglecting the sacrifices, hastened to be partakers of the unlawful.
You see what happened? You see what happened? You play sports. You play evil, wicked sports. You're not going to want to do God's law. You see, they just start despising the temple.
Yeah.
We start despising God's laws because we want to play football.
Mm-hmm.
And that happens right now today in the truth. A lot of young people, bro.
Yep.
What they come in, a lot of the young parents come up to us.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, my son want to play football. Oh, he didn't want to come to the Sabbath today because they got a game.
Mm-hmm.
You see what I'm saying?
Yep.
That's some evil stuff.
Yep.
That's why it's not our custom. We shouldn't be participating in that. As repentant Israelites, we shouldn't be participating. As Israelites, the blacks and Spaniards, we shouldn't be participating in that garbage.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, read on.
That the priests had no courage to serve anymore at the altar, but despising the temple and neglecting the sacrifices, hastened to be partakers of the unlawful allowance in the place of exercise after the game of discus called them forth.
You see that? You hear what God say? Unlawful,
unlawful
allowance of place of exercise. So is football lawful?
No.
No, sir.
No, we ain't playing that garbage.
Right.
We ain't going out like that. Watch this. Read on. Verse 15.
Not setting by the honors of their fathers, but liking the glory of the Grecians best of all.
That's what our people like, the glory of the Grecians best of all.
Yeah.
That's the glory of the Grecians, what they doing right there in Sin City.
Right.
Glory of the Grecians. They glorifying the damn white man who hates your guts.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Now, I just sent you a video, man. I'm finna show y'all. I'm finna show you how we love the damn heathen. You see what I sent you? Look, we do all they rituals, bruh.
Mm-hmm.
These folk hate us.
Right.
All that we go out and we teach our people, and a lot of times these Greek fraternities and sororities show up out there.
Right.
We try to tell them, look, we was in slavery under these people. These people was killing us.
Mm.
But yet and still today, our women want to be Greeks.
Well,
you see that last clip I just sent you? I mean, that Instagram I just sent you? All right, play that right there. I just want to play a little of it to show the wicked customs that our people are in. These folk hate us, man. I'm telling you. Watch this, man. This is what they go on at these college campuses.
Here's the reason why. Of all the towns around, I searched no better group I found. So I joined them right away. And this I have to say. We have tried. Now we made it to AKA. And Alpha, Kappa, Alpha, and Alpha, Kappa,
look at the wicked rituals.
My pillow is filled like lead.
These are all women, black women, want to join this Greek sorority. You see this?
Yep.
That's why, bro. Look, you can take it down, bro.
Hey, but you know
this,
what?
This is what happens on college campuses. Our people want to be Greeks.
Yep.
It was all sisters.
Yep.
Bruh.
All black women. Whole damn herd of them.
Yeah.
Go ahead, officer.
Do we have a picture of like us? Can we find one of us?
Are you talking about
us
marching? Yeah. Find a picture of us marching, officer.
Real quick.
Yeah, but I just want to say, this right here, what they was doing is not setting by the customs of our father,
right,
but loving the glory of the heathen best of all. They say being a Greek is gonna make you a better person. That's what they say. Yeah. Yeah. That's what they say. Yeah. Not knowing that these people was murdering us. Mm-hmm. We are the Israelites. We the Jews.
Right.
These damn Greeks was murdering you sisters.
Mm-hmm. Right.
They was murdering the black woman for trying to circumcise a son. Mm. You see what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But that show you how destroyed our people the ears off. But today, you paying money to join these sororities. And all those sororities do is promote whoredom. I'm telling you, a lot of them, they want you to sleep with men.
Yep.
To get in the sorority.
Yep.
And
yep.
stuff. It's all whoredom, all yep. kind of hazing, all that garbage going on to be in this Greekish fashion. Hmm. Greekish fashion.
If we could plug this in real quick, you know, because that right there is what you would call African Americans, mm-hmm. or really the Israelites, mm-hmm. who want to be Greeks.
Right. Yep.
This
right.
is why the Bible called you Gentiles.
Exactly.
This right. is right. loss right. of exactly. identity. Yep. You exactly. basically sell your identity and your soul to be a Greek. Mm-hmm. That's why he said he had to go to the Gentiles, mm-hmm. because you claim to be Greek.
Mm-hmm. Yes, sir. All right. 2 Maccabees chapter 6, verse 10, officer. Why are we looking for getting the image there?
2 Maccabees chapter 6, verse 10.
Mm-hmm. Read up.
For there were two women mm-hmm. who were brought, mm-hmm. who had circumcised their children, mm-hmm. whom when they had openly led round about the city, mm-hmm. the babes hanging at their breasts, mm-hmm. they cast them down headlong from the wall.
You see this? Mm-hmm. You see what they did to us for keeping God's laws? They mm-hmm. circumcised their kids. They killed them damn kids.
Right. Right.
But today,
right.
you got a whole damn herd of our women want to be Greeks.
Yep. Mm.
And Abba, oh, they had a little song praising that garbage. Yeah. And I think they worship one of them Greek gods. I forgot the name of that god. Matter of fact, I'm going to Google it right quick. Go ahead, officer. I'm going to Google this guy.
It's over there?
Yeah.
Okay, we just said, officer, you know, you got to think about that in history. You know, our people don't know. It's like when we come off those slave ships, think about this. What the masters of those plantation do? Stood us up there and got the best of the best, right? Mm-hmm. What's the difference? Same thing today, no combines mm-hmm. in the NFL. Mm-hmm. They're doing the same thing, the criminal mm-hmm. crop, then what they do, draft them in rounds. They just right. send them to the plantation, Philadelphia.
Right.
Houston or whatever the plantation may be. Like back then, it might be in North Carolina, Jackson, Mississippi, but now the big cities mm-hmm. where the NFL teams are, mm-hmm. Houston, Tampa Bay, that's the plantation they send us to now. Mm-hmm. But right. people don't see that. They yeah. lost contact with what happened in the past, but like I said, that gift destroy our heart, that money,
yep.
that fun out there in Vegas, mm-hmm. yep. we don't give a damn about that. You know?
We blinded. Right.
They blinded. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Play Officer Benaiah's video one more time.
Can y'all speed it up a little bit? I want to show you the amount of our sisters that's in this evil ritual.
And here's the reason why.
Now play us. Okay, all praises.
Yeah,
all
that's
praises,
a good one.
Right? That's a real good one right there. Mm-hmm. All right, so when our people see those AKAs, right, mm-hmm. they call it sisterhood.
Mm-hmm.
But when they see us marching through the neighborhoods like this right here, they say that's a cult.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I'm confused. Mm-hmm. Now, I can read about what we're doing right there
yeah.
in the Bible.
Right.
Right. But what they're doing in those fraternities and in those colleges, mm-hmm. those sororities, mm-hmm. I can't read that.
Right.
I can read that it's sin.
Right.
You mm-hmm. see what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But when we doing what we doing, that's considered righteousness. That's of God right there.
Mm-hmm.
And we're going to read about it real quick. Give me Ezekiel 37. Ezekiel
All
37.
Praise. All praise.
And verse 10.
Ezekiel chapter 37. Verse 10.
Bring it out.
So I prophesied as he commanded me,
mm-hmm.
and the breath came into them,
read.
And they lived and stood up upon their feet, an exceeding great army.
So when the commandments came to us, when we heard the word of God, the true word of God, we ain't talking about what we've been taught in Christianity and all these different strange religions that we've been taught all our lives, right? Mm-hmm. We talking about the true word of God,
right?
When we heard that, we stood up on our feet, right? When we heard the commandments of God, we stood up like an army.
Right.
Read it again.
So I prophesied as he commanded me, and the breath came into them, and they lived and stood up upon their feet, an exceeding great army.
And that's what you're seeing right there. That's what you're seeing out of us, an exceeding great army. That's a large army right there, marching through your cities, marching through your streets. You're seeing an exceeding great army of God.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Not no garbage like we played a few minutes ago in them sororities. Right. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. That's idolatry. Now give me one more scripture real quick. Go to Joel. Joel chapter 2. Read verse 7 first.
Okay. Joel chapter 2 verse 7.
Because people, like I said, people will say we a cult. Right. When they see us, the men like that marching through the cities, they say we a cult, right? They see our women dressed the same, they say we a cult. But when you see that garbage right there, you proud. For some reason, you get proud and say congratulations.
That's sisterhood right there.
Right, yeah. That's sisterhood. But you see our women and children, you say, oh, they in a cult.
They in a cult.
They're slaves.
Yeah.
They're slaves.
Yep.
Huh. Read that.
Joel chapter 2, verse 7. They shall run like mighty men. They shall climb the wall like the men of war.
That's what we're going to do. We're going to be great men again. Read on, though. Watch this.
And they shall march every one on his ways.
They shall do what?
March every one on his ways.
Ain't that what we do?
Yep. That's right.
Read.
And they shall not break their ranks.
And we don't break our ranks. We in order.
Right.
We men that's in order. And our people need to see that.
Right.
Now jump down to verse 11.
Verse 11. And the Lord shall utter his voice before his army.
When we come through the streets, you hear us chanting. Right? Mm-hmm. That's the voice of God right there.
Right.
Read.
And the Lord shall utter his voice before his army.
Before his what?
Before his army.
Before his army. That's what you're seeing.
Right.
You're seeing God's army on display.
Right.
Read.
Right. For his camp is very great.
And God's camp is very great. That's just minute right there, what you're seeing.
Right.
That's just a piece.
Right. Right.
That's just the tip of the iceberg right there.
Right.
You ain't seen nothing yet.
Right. Did you read that part where they stood up on their feet?
Yes, sir.
They seen on. Read it again, bro. When you see images like that, Ezekiel 37. Go back and play the images for our people. So these men and that you see in the video, we have repented. We keeping the commandments of God.
Right.
God say when we do that, we're exceeding great army of the Lord. You ain't never seen nothing like this in the earth.
Never.
Men, black men standing up for the laws of God, marrying our women, taking care of our kids, keeping the Sabbath day. You ain't never seen nothing like this.
No.
But it's a blackout on us.
It's a blackout on us.
Right. They want to show us as evil.
Right.
Okay. They want to show us as baby daddies, beating our women, not taking care of our kids, but they ain't showing that though.
No, right. They call that a hate that. Group. A
they say we're a hate group.
You know what I'm saying? But then you show these AKAs, these whores,
right,
and glorify them.
Right. You say that's good.
Yeah.
Evil is good.
Mm-hmm.
Read that.
Ezekiel chapter 37, verse 10. So I prophesied as he commanded me.
That's what God has did. We have prophesied. And now this breath of God is coming in us.
Right.
You know?
And the breath came into them.
Uh-huh.
And they lived.
And they did what?
And they lived.
That's what we doing. We living now. We keeping the commandments of God. Read.
Right. And stood upon their feet.
Uh-huh.
An exceeding great army.
You see that? We standing on our feet, an exceeding great army, and the damn Edomites hate it.
Right.
They want to keep us at the damn Super Bowl.
Right.
We ain't going to the Super Bowl.
Right.
We keeping the commandments of God. We ain't going. You can't get us with the damn Super Bowl.
Right.
We know now. We know what's going on. We know that that's a distraction. Super Bowl is a distraction to keep our people in sin. We ain't doing that garbage no more. The rebel baby said, don't say my name no more. Don't say my name no more. We ain't doing that crap no more.
Hey, yo, man. Y'all got something else? That's our show, man. What's up? Anybody got something else to bring out?
I got one more thing.
Hey, go ahead, Austin.
Real quick, Austin. I just want to go back to that second Ezra chapter 4 real quick. Mm-hmm. I want to pull something out of that real
all
fast.
All praises.
Man.
All praises.
Second Ezra chapter 4. Read that 14 again.
Second Ezra chapter 4, verse 14.
Mm-hmm. Read out.
And said, come, let us go and make war against the sea.
I'm sorry, not second Ezra.
Oh, first.
Second Maccabees.
Second Maccabees, 4:15. I'm sorry. Not saying about the way of their father.
Yeah.
Second
Maccabees, 4:14, right quick.
Second Maccabees, chapter 4, and verse 14. That the priests had no courage to serve anymore at the altar,
mm-hmm.
but despising the temple
mm-hmm.
and neglecting the sacrifices, mm-hmm. hastened to be partakers of the unlawful allowance in the place of exercise
mm-hmm.
after the game of discus called them forth.
Now we know these pastors in these Christian churches mm-hmm. ain't the real priests.
Right.
All right. Mm-hmm. But they do have the similar character. They do carry these traits, right?
Right.
You see what I'm saying? Because mm-hmm. every Christian church today is already let out.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
They had quick service today. Yeah. You know why?
Damn.
Because all of them want to be partakers in that Super Bowl.
Right.
Yeah. Right.
They say, I ain't going to hold you long today. We're going to get out of here early today.
Yeah. Super Bowl Sunday.
Yeah. And I wanted to show that that image right there. It was a Roman writer mm-hmm. that had wrote this. Mm-hmm. He said, give them bread and circuses, mm-hmm. and they will never revolt.
Dang.
That's true to this day. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Give us a little food, a little money, and entertainment, mm-hmm. we'll be distracted. We'll never revolt. We'll never see the truth.
Mm-hmm.
Never ever rise up as a great nation.
And you know what? I ain't trying to – the thing – when you say that right there about us revolting, that's what we trying to do. Right. It's a revolution.
Right.
We got to have a revolutionary mindset. And if I could just read one scripture, I ain't going to be long. It's Revelation 1, right? Mm-hmm. Revelation 1 and verse 6. Because our people may be asking, what is our option then? If I'm so good at football, if I'm so good at basketball, what else can I do? Mm-hmm. When we look at LeBron James, we call him what? The king.
Mm-hmm.
He the king of what?
Mm-hmm.
The NBA? That ain't no nation.
Right.
Right.
God say, what I built you for was to be a king of this earth.
That's right.
A king of this world, but you can't do it with these distractions with sports. Right. Read that, Revelation 1 and 6.
The book of Revelation, chapter 1, verse 6.
Uh-huh. Read it out.
And had made us kings and priests
uh-huh.
unto God and his Father. To him be glory and dominion forever and ever.
That's what the Lord trying to give us. He trying to give us dominion on this earth. It starts by knowing that you are a king, not a basketball player or a football player.
Right.
I'm going to read one last scripture, then we're going to shut it down, because a lot of people will be like, well, what's wrong with the Super Bowl? It promotes sin. Okay? It's sin. It's heathenish customs. Okay? It ain't got nothing to do with serving the Most High God. Okay? Give me Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 6. Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 6. Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 6. The Lord want us to do what he put us here to do. Okay, read that.
Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 6.
Uh-huh. Read it out.
Therefore thou shalt keep the commandments of the Lord thy God.
That's what God want us to do. Keep his commandments. That's why we went into slavery. That's why we're at the bottom right now.
Mm-hmm.
That's why the reason why we're at the bottom, because our people like to do this stuff going on at the damn Super Bowl.
Right.
Read on.
To walk in his ways.
To do what?
To walk in his ways.
Walk at the Super Bowl, you're not walking in God's ways.
Right.
You're walking in the heathen ways. You're walking in the Greeks, the Romans, all of their ways. Okay? That it?
And to fear him.
And to fear him. If you had fear of God, you wouldn't be at the damn Super Bowl.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? You wouldn't be having a Super Bowl party at your house.
Mm-hmm.
You know what they're doing. Super Bowl parties at the house. Jake go on vacation all this week. Jake go on vacation all this week for the Super Bowl. A lot of folk going to call in all this week for the damn Super Bowl. Mm-hmm. Okay? I'm telling you, they say they days.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Our people say they days to take off the whole week for the Super Bowl. Oh, I'm having a Super Bowl party.
Yeah.
I ain't going to work.
ain't going to work.
Yeah.
But Lord's will, our people repent and change their mindset on that. That stuff is evil and it's keeping us in sin.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But hey, yo, that's our show, yo. If y'all ever in the Tupelo, Mississippi area, come and visit the school. We meet every Sabbath day at 1 o'clock. Okay. Check us out on all our social media platforms. Like, subscribe, and share. Help us out on YouTube. Subscribe to our channel. Check us out on Rumble. Rumble now. Subscribe to our Rumble. Okay. Subscribe to our Instagram. Hit us up on TikTok. We'll be sharing videos. Check us out. We'll be sharing camp videos where we go out and on the street and teach our people 2-3 times a week. We share videos like that. So check us out. Like, subscribe, and share. And with that, we say shalom. Shalom.